Hey guys, it's Meg. If you are new to the channel, welcome. If you are a returning viewer, then welcome back. Today I wanted to talk to you guys about the makeup that I brought traveling at my wedding. Since it was a destination wedding, I was also gonna do my own makeup. I didn't want anybody else to do my makeup, so I brought my own makeup, and it actually all fit in this one little bag, okay? With the exception of my setting spray and my brushes, every single makeup item that I used is in this little bag. In fact, there are a few things in here that I didn't even get to use. So I actually wanted to show you what I brought. First things first, maybe I'll show you the stuff that didn't actually fit in there, like my Urban Decay setting spray, which I used and really helped to keep my makeup in place the whole day in the humidity of Bali. I mean, you would not believe how humid it was. I mean, anyway, and then I brought some of my brushes. These are my trusted brushes that I have been using every single day, face and eye brushes. I have a lot of eye brushes because, you know, very particular with what I'm supposed to do with my eyes. I'm not gonna individually show you what those are. I've got my Real Technique sponge as well as the Beamy makeup brush cleaner that I got from Kmart for like $6. I think the Vera Mode one is something like almost $20 on Sephora US. This was in Kmart Australia. Anyways, so what is in this little makeup bag? I'll show you. I'll probably start with the main stuff. So I use my foundations, the MAC Studio Fix Fluid. This one is an NC35 and this one is an NC40. The reason why I brought two is because I spent a lot of time at the beach and I actually ended up being a little bit more tanned than I expected on my wedding day. So NC40 was actually perfect for me. Okay. And obviously at the end of this video, I'll show you the makeup that I did. But if you watched my bridal look number two, which was the purple eye look, that was what I did at the wedding. Okay, so those are the bases. I've got my NARS Pro Prime Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Base. I usually use my Milani one on a daily basis, but because this was a special occasion and I wanted my eyeshadow to last a lifetime, just like my marriage, then I used the NARS Eye Proof. Now, I brought up a few eyeshadow palettes because I wasn't sure what I would do, but I ended up, using them anyway. I brought my Make It Forever 15 Artist Shadow Palette, and also the Volume 2 of the 9 Pan Palette. If you don't know what that looks like, that's the inside of the 15 Pan Palette. And this is the inside of Volume 2, because I wanted that purple right there. I wish I could have like removed it from the palette and just brought that with me, because honestly, these are quite weighted. They're a bit heavy. And I also brought my Viseart Petite Pro eyeshadow palette, because none of those eyeshadows in those two palettes are matte, so I needed my transition shades and everything, so I had those for my eyeshadow. I also brought my Lorac Pro Contour palette for contouring, obviously. And I don't know if you can see it, but I'm really getting a lot of use on those contour shades, not so much on the highlighters. And then for highlighter and for blush, I used my Becca collaboration with Chrissy Teigen. I hear she's coming out with another one. I saw a sneak peek and I am excited for it because I truly enjoy this one here. Obviously, I used the blush. Let's see. I used the blush and I used this particular highlighter there. This is Beach Nectar, which is limited to this particular palette, and it was gorgeous, I gotta say. I loved it. Okay, so those were the palettes that I brought, as well as my concealer palette from MAC. This is the Pro Conceal and Correct palette in medium. And as you can see, I have been using a hell of a lot of this palette as well. I've used pretty much all of the shades in here. Now, for the small stuff, for mascara, I actually brought two things. This is the Estee Lauder Black primer mascara. I don't know, all the writing has rubbed off, but that's what it is. And this is the Blink mascara as well, which is a tubing mascara, and it really like coats your lashes with mascara. Okay. Also brought as well, I don't know, yeah, the Revlon Precision lash glue. This is my favorite. It works wonders. But the Daiso one in the orange packaging does just as good a job as this one. But I just really wanted to use this because it was humid there and I wasn't sure if the Daiso one would withstand that kind of humidity. Eyebrows, I brought my Essence Make Me Brow. And this is in the color, what are you? Brownie Brows 02. I think I could do with, I think there's a darker one called Espresso, but this does a really good job with my eyebrows anyway. But I also brought my Anastasia brow pomade in dark brown, which is what I have on my brows today. Because it was an evening reception, I needed to make sure that my features were enhanced, okay? For eyeliner, I brought two. I brought the Maybelline Hyper Sharp Wing and the Kat Von D Trooper in black. And I didn't get to use either of these at the wedding because I didn't want to risk them smudging and making a mess in my eyes. But I've had no issues with them doing that anyway in the first place. But because of the humidity, I just didn't want to risk it. I did use the Lancome Liquid Pencil. Drama Liquid Pencil Noir Intense. This one in my waterline and in my into tight line to make the appearance of my lashes look like they are fuller. And of course my trusty smooth operator from Tarte loose powder to mattify my face, and then of course I spritz it again with the Urban Decay makeup setting spray. Are you liking my makeup? This is actually a reaction to that April Fool's joke of Tarte, which was their Icy Betch palette, which, jokes on you Tarte, there were a lot of people who actually wanted that palette, and now you gave away that idea to other companies and didn't realize that, whoa, people actually wanted to see a non-brown, non-red, non-rusty palette, you know? Anyways, and then for lip products, I've got three lip liners here. They're all from Essence because they are my favorite lip liner brand. They're so creamy and so pigmented. So this one's here, which I never really actually got to use because I ended up using my Dose of Color liquid lipstick in Truffle, and this did not budge. It did not move the whole evening. Okay. And as an alternative, and what I'm wearing today on my lips is the NARS Audacious Lipstick in Vanessa. These two shades are actually very, very close to each other, if not the same, except that this is creamier and it's not transfer proof, whereas a Dose of Color actually really stays on. And that's it. That is what's in my makeup travel wedding bag, if you would. Let me know if you like this video, and I would be doing a little bit more of that every time I travel, tell you what are the stuff that I bring with me. And let's just address the elephant in the room. I did get a haircut. I've been waiting to get a haircut like this, but I just wanted the wedding to be done, and then I would get a haircut, and I did get this haircut. I think it suits me. Don't you agree? And it also allows me to do a little bit of an edgier look, because I think haircuts like this, especially if like I style it, that's a little bit more, you know, I could definitely get away with edgier looks. The reason why I don't really do a lot of edgy looks is because I am lazy with my hair and I never know what to do with it when I've got such a glamorous or such an edgy rock star chic kind of look. But today, I just let it go. So there you have it. If you have any questions on the products that I brought with me, and I'm going to go ahead and link down below as well the bridal look number two that I did, which was the look that I did on the actual wedding day. I'm going to link that in the description bar below. And yeah, comment if you have any questions or reactions, whether they be nice or violent or whatever. you go ahead. Subscribe if you haven't already, and if you don't want to miss any of my videos, please click on the bell icon so that you are notified of when I put up videos. I try to do at least 3 times a week. Sometimes I do a little bit more depending on how much time I have in my hands. Anyway, I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye.